dreaming this, right? You're not seriously waking me up again.
The detectives who searched Hank Prince's home found the taxi receipt, just like he said they would. They identified the cab driver, they showed him photographs of Prince and his girlfriend, Sloane Teller. He ID'd the both of them, remembered them vividly, mostly Miss Teller, vividly.
I haven't even met her, and I can picture her vividly. But so what? The guy has an alibi. He could have hired anyone to shoot his wife.
Would you hire someone to kill someone for you? Go to the trouble of establishing an alibi and then hand that person your gun to commit the crime? For the time being, Mr. Prince has been released from custody. And until a better theory presents itself, I believe we must continue operating under our previous assumption that someone is targeting Prince in an effort to undermine the Hound.
I get that framing the head of a company for murder could throw a hitch in his business plan, but it's a hell of a long way to go.
Precisely the reason that I think we need to focus our attention on an individual disposed to going to such lengths. Last night, you mentioned a likely home for our corporate saboteur, a company called Radnor Science.
I wasn't even sure you heard that.
Well, not only did I hear it, I spent most of the night considering it, and I have concluded that I agree. I read the autobiography of its CEO, Charles, call me Chuck, Hammond, and he's just the kind of Sun Tzu quoting, take no prisoners corporate executive that one might expect to ignore all boundaries of moral decency. Plus, the company is developing a device in direct competition to the Hound. However, from what I can infer from the internet, they may be as much as 1 year behind in the race. Come on.
Are you okay? You seem hyper.
I may have had a coffee or three with my tea this morning.